I'm Dena Higbee. I'm with the University of Missouri. I'm the Executive Director of Simulation for the School of Medicine, Sinclair School of Nursing, and the College of Veterinary Medicine. Behind me is our new mobile simulation track, and let's step inside and take a tour. In this room, we have an adult mannequin in here named Hal, and with him, you'll see that his eyes blink. They're reactive to light. You can have both lungs inflating, or you can have right lung or left lung, so if one were deflated. And then you can also take all of his pulses. So as you feel for the normal pulse locations, then what you're seeing and hearing in the simulator is exactly what is happening to your patient. In this room, you'll notice that we also have a head wall, and this head wall allows us to be able to mimic everything that you would do in a clinical setting. So whether or not you need to apply oxygen or if you need to do suctioning of your patient, you can do so as you normally would. Up above, the vital sign monitor allows the providers to actually see what's happening with their patients. So after they've already done a health assessment, then they have confirmation from the vital signs to be able to keep track of any changes that might be occurring as they're caring for the patient. Any kind of healthcare scenario that you can experience in either EMS or in a hospital setting, we can mimic with this kind of an adult simulator. This room is very similar to the other room that we were just in. In both rooms, we have cameras in the ceiling, both above the head of the bed and in the back corner. And that allows us to be able to record what is happening in the room so we can play it back outside or in another room. And so we do have another TV monitor on the outside of this vehicle that allows us to either use it for marketing purposes to let people understand what simulation is, or we can actually play back what has happened inside of a room, or we can also play it as live video so they can see it while it's happening in real time. So this little guy here is Hal Jr. So very similar to the adult mannequins, you have eyes that will blink, the head will actually move. If I'm talking to him on one side versus the other side, he will tilt his head and look at me. If he is not breathing as well, he might turn blue around the mouth. And that would indicate to us that maybe he's not getting as much oxygen as what you would like. He has a lot more electronics built into him, as you can see, so he can actually respond appropriately to what's happening.
Who are you?
You can see his chest rising. He has the vital signs for heart rate, respiration rate, and so forth that you can do as well. This room would also house one of the other demographic of patients that we have. So we have infants, we have pediatrics, we have adults, and we also have obstetric patients. So behind me is a control room where we're able to control all of the simulators that are in both rooms. It allows us to make all of the physiological changes to it off of the laptop. And it also allows us to see the video and the vital signs that are happening in each simulation room as they're occurring. We're very excited about the mobile sim program. We're very fortunate to be able to offer this through the university, which really sets us apart from other institutions across the country. And we're very happy that you're able to join us on this tour today.